today I'm here with a new video, and I am so excited for this video because I'm doing a first impression of the new collection from Kaleidos makeup. And I got sent this in PR, and this is my third or fourth, I don't know, I think it's my fourth PR package from Kaleidos, and I am still like, I can't like understand that I get PR from them. And I got the suitcase and the whole new collection, the Fresh Fantasy collection. And this suitcase, I'm going to save this. I don't know what I want to do with it, but I'm going to save it because it's really, really cool. And I'm just going to put it away. This collection contains two new Futurism palettes, so there are 6 pen palettes, and 3 contour kits, and 1 lip gloss, and also this little bow. This was in the PR kit, and you can also, from Kaleidos, buy the PR kits. So yeah, I am going to try everything in this video, so I'm going to do 1 look which is of each of the palettes, try 1 of the contour kits. But I can show you everything first, and then I will leave timestamps down in the description when I start. So the new palettes are number 6, that is Lunar Lavender, and number 7, that is Sashimi City. And this Sashimi City. Hard. is their neutral palette. And a thing that is a little bit unusual with these, you open them, this is just the box, you open them like this, and then the palette was in here. So the palettes are their 6 pen palettes, and some of the other Futurism palettes are some of my absolute favorites. And unfortunately, my came smashed. I think it was 1 color in this and 2 colors in the other one of the shimmers were smashed. I pressed them down, but they maybe not look their best. And the Lunar Lavender looks like this. I love that they are doing more Futurism palettes. And I'm a little bit afraid to hold this up because I'm afraid that the shade is going to fall out. It was this shade that came smashed, but other than that, all the other hold up, but it's like glitter in all the palette. I've tried to clean it the best as I can, and that color is like a multichrome or a duochrome. I think it looks like only blue for you, but it's blue and purple. You know me, I am so shitty at showing duochromes. And the Sashimi City palette, here it was 2 colors, so it was both of the shimmers. It looks kind of okay. It is quite a lot of shimmers, but I've swatched them and doesn't seem to be anything wrong with them. So this is Kaleidos' take on a neutral palette, and I think I like it, even though it's a neutral palette. And then if we go into the contour kits, I got all 3 of them. So one is, maybe I could take them out. They also comes in these little package, and you open them like these, and then the contour kit is in here. So it is 3 different colors. So the first one, the one that I am going to use, is Cool and Light. And they all contain 3 colors, so I'm going to use this today and try it out, and I really hope that it will look good. I think it is. It's get this little sleeve with it, or plastic, that is Fill, Shade, and Chisel. And on the box, or in the box, it says how you should use them. So, yeah, this is the Cool and Light. And then it is also the Warm and Medium. And this is too dark for me. It is the same, so it's one lighter shade. I guess it's like a bronzer, contour, and a setting powder. Maybe for your under eyes. So this was the medium and warm. Warm and medium, maybe. And then the last one is warm and deep. It looks like this. And this is, of course, too deep for me. So, yeah, I'm going to use this one. And then the lip gloss is Dramatize. It looks like it's reddish pink or red orange and has like a gold shimmer to it. So I will use this in at least one of the looks. So yeah, I think we just get started. So I will start with number 6, that is Lunar Lavender. I didn't press record. So I have start with a Lunar Lavender and I'm going to try to use all the shades. How can I not press record? It's like the third time this happens. And I start and then like the camera shuts off and I'm like, what? So I'm going to try to use all the shades and I haven't swatched any of these except for the shimmers because I just wanted to see how they were. So I have started with this one in my crease. And as I said to the camera that wasn't recording, I really like this shade. It is a coal toned brown. But I think it has, I don't know, I just really like it. I think now when I have it on my eyes, it really like goes together with a Lunar Lavender theme. That feels nice. And I haven't, I can't like even remember what I said to you in the recording camera. Yeah, when I swatched the shimmers, they felt a little bit more like topper shades, if I'm not mistaken. I haven't swatched them now, maybe I should just do it. So these are the shimmers and I don't know, because I don't know if I want to take a glitter glue or not. I might do that. But I will go in with this a little bit darker purple and have it like outer corner of my eye. And then I'm going to use a lot of shimmers on my eyelid. And I haven't watched like any videos on this because I wanted to test them out myself first. And it has been kind of hard, actually. Okay, I think this is might like a little bit lighter than I thought it would be. Still goes really good, so I have nothing against it at all. And why did I start with my left eye? I like never do that. So far, I'm really happy with this. It's now I don't know if I want to take both of the shimmers on my lid or not. I'm not sure at all. But maybe I'm going to start with this shimmer and just see how it picks up on the brush. And I will see if I feel like I might need my glitter primer or not. Because swatching it with your finger and then put it on your eye is not the same. I actually think I want to, or maybe I should. I'm going to change my plans. Yes, I actually think I will do that. So I will go in with this other lighter purple and take it on the rest of my lid. And then, oh, this was very pastel, very pastel-y, but I like it. It might didn't go as good as with my crease color as the darker purple did, but I don't really mind if I'm going to be honest. Maybe it was just my blend that wasn't that good. And I feel like this collection is called Fantasy Fresh. Fresh Fantasy. And it feels like it is not like the two latest Futurism palettes they released were VR Neon and Electro Turquoise, and they are extremely like in your face, and this feels a little bit more lighter, a little bit more toned down. I like it. So far, I like it, and I think this works really good. It's now I'm realizing that I have like the deepest brown for my lower lash. Shoot. Okay, and now I will take the dark purple shimmer and I will first put it on top of the lighter purple I have on my inner half. And this might not be. Maybe I should use my fingers or I just need to press it on. Yeah, press it onwards. It feels like this shade is kind of like the one in the Astro Pink that is a duochrome, and that is so much better when you have like a glitter primer under or you just have to like more pack it on than smudge it around. And I think that this works. Good, I just want to try to blend it out a little bit to the darker purple. So I'm just going in with the darker purple. Darker purple. Just out here. Just smudge it a little bit together and then I go over with the shimmer yet again. And yeah, I think I like this. And yes, I did just say that I like a purple look that I have done, and it feels like it's been a lot of pink and purple the latest. And this was really like, if you are not going to use a glitter primer, or yeah, cut your crease or cut your halo or cut your lid, I think it's better to just pack it on and not try to smudge it out. And if you have the Astro Pink, I think this is pretty similar to that really cool, awesome shade in the Astro Pink. So, yeah. Okay, so I think I am happy with the lids like this. I'm trying to like more purple. I'm really, really trying. And I think this is like the kind of purple I need to do, like a little bit lighter purple. And I don't know. But I like the lids like this, so I'm going to take away the fallouts, fix my base, but we are going to test out this together. It's going to be really fun. I think I might just use these two. I will see how this looks. I have to see how pigmented it is as well. So maybe I should swatch it, but do I ever do that? No, I do not. So let me just fix my base and my brows. Almost my whole base and my brows, and then I come back. I'm in middle in the middle in my in blah, blah, blah. I'm in the middle of doing my base, so I'm going to go in with the contour palette now, and I am going to use the cool and the light. So I'm going to use these two, and I hope that I can use this as a contour because I think I'm going to try to do that. It doesn't look warm and it is cool, so I'm going to take this chisel shade. They don't have any names, it's just fill. What was it even? Fill shade and chisel? Yeah. So I'm going to take that one. This contour. And as you might know, I hate to do this on camera, but if we're trying this. Okay, maybe we should just stop. My contour shade that I have now is not that pigmented, and there is some, okay, this wasn't either. And that is something I like, because I hate it when it is too, like, pigmented. And I don't know, can you see any difference? If I look in the viewfinder, I think I can see a difference. And I do not do much contour. I never do bronzer because I, for some reason, I think that bronzer doesn't suit my pale skin. But I think I really like this shade. It is really like, I'm really pale. Usually say that I am pale as a paper, and I almost am. And this doesn't look, yeah, I'm going to contour my chin. I think it doesn't look much, and now I didn't take much, but I like how it looks. I can see it. I don't know if you can see any difference, but I like it. So, yeah, I really do. And I might think that we can take, because I'm going to use one of their blushes as well. This is in the Lo-Fi Rose Duo Blusher, and I'm going to use Mood this one. So maybe we can do this together as well. So I never can remember if these are pigmented or not. But I actually think that they are discontinued, these blushes. Because they came out with two lip palettes in their collection before this one. And I think that these are no longer available. But I am not sure. I like them. But it is not my favorite from Kaleidos. But I like them. And I do not do heavy face makeup at all. I just like a little bit. And for highlighter, I'm going to take one of the highlights from Kaleidos. This one is one of my favorites. This is Star Surfer. And I have had this for a long time. And this is a pinkish one. And I know that this was a first impression of the new collection, but I was thinking if you want to buy something from Kaleidos, I can show you a little bit more than just the new collection, because maybe you don't want to buy the whole collection. I don't know. So now you get a little sneak peek of... Sneak peek. Now you get a little... Oh my god! I'm so sorry. I really like this highlighter. I'm just going to spritz my face, but I think that the contour kit, I really like it actually, or the contour palette. So it's time for my under eyes, and where have I put a palette? So for my under eyes, I think I really want to use this darker brown, but I don't know. Maybe I just deepen down my outer corner. So I think I actually want to take... I think I start with this lighter purple and take it... Maybe it's lavender, because it's lunar lavender. So I take this underneath my eye. And kind of smudge it out. And then, yes, because I want to use all the shades, I'm going to go in with this deep brown. And take it, like, just on my... Take just a little bit. And... Just put it here. And then I am going in with the last shade in the palette that I haven't used. This one. And can you guess what I'm going to do? Spray it and put it in my inner corner. And I'm going to spray it because I don't want this to fall on my face, because then I'm going to be mad. This looks more like a little bit of pink shade. So this goes really good together with my highlighter, I would say. Let like I ever have cared about that before. Okay, so the lids are done and all the eyes and face are done. So I'm going to put on mascara, take something from my waterline, choose a lippy. I actually think I will save the lip gloss for the other look because I think it will go better with that look, whatever I will do. So I will put on mascara and a lippy and then come back. So this is finished look for my waterline. I took Crybaby from ColourPop, and on my lips I took one of the lip tonics from Kaleidos, that is Immersion, and also a lip gloss Crystallize, and I thought that this was going to match the eyes a little bit because this is like purple and blue and this is like purple and blue. I like this palette. I am going to do a review after the other look with the other palette. So if you want to see my review, you can just keep on watching or you can skip to the review part. As I said, all the timestamps will be down in the description. But I like this look. I maybe would want a little bit more punch in this color, but I think that this color is pretty similar to the Astro Pink Duochrome shade. But other than that, I am happy with the look. I like this palette. I love that they have come out with new Futurism palettes because I just love them. So if you want to see the look I am going to do with Sashimi City, just stick around. It is time for the next one. So it is Futurism 7 Sashimi City. And you see, I put on my sushi shirt. I actually have two. So this is one of my sushi shirts and I was like, okay, this is going to match. So the Sashimi City looks like this. So the two shimmers in this one was smashed as well. I tried my best to press them in. I don't think they are like too messed up. So yeah, this is the more neutral palette, I think. This is the most neutral palette Kaleidos has done. So I'm going to do a look and I will try to use all the shades. So this might not be super exciting for you that love colors, but yeah. I'm going to start with this one in my crease and then see maybe this one as well. And then I'm going to do a shimmer lid. Maybe deepen it down with this one or this one. I think I need to swatch them before I decide which one. So, and I actually, before I tried the Lunar Lavender, I didn't watch any videos with that. So okay, when I am done with this look, I'm going to watch my friends that have done looks with these two palettes. First I was like, okay, maybe I should, after I test the Lunar Lavender, watch what they thought about that one. But I was like, okay, I'm never going to like stop in the middle of a video, so I need to do my first impression with this one as well, and then I can watch. So I got some videos to watch now because there is more than one of my friends here on YouTube that got it in PR, so yeah, I have things to do tonight. Okay, I like this color. It's nice. Nothing super special. Then I am going in with this one and deepen down my crease and we will see how this works. Hopefully good. I don't know why I typed them off because I usually never do that. Okay, maybe this would have been nice to have underneath or on my lower lash line, but we have it here and I like it. And I understand why they might want to do a neutral palette because I know that not everybody loves colors as I do and people just want to try Kaleidos even though you're not a super colorful fan when it comes to makeup. So I guess that is good. And yeah, I don't know where I wanted to go with this. And now we have a visitor. Astrid is back. Yes, you are. And we have tried, like my boyfriend tried to have her with him in the living room. She do not want to be with him. I don't know why. So I'm going to swatch these two browns in the end and see which one I want to deepen down my crease with. Or not my crease, but take on my outer corner. So these are the two. They are not super different. But I think I'm going to take this darker one. Just because I think the other one is going to look better on my lower lash line. And now she's going out. Maybe I wasn't that fun today. So I'm going to take the darker matte. So I think it was this one. And take it out here. And the thing I think is a little bit different with this palette. And now she's back. It feels like almost all the other palettes from Kaleidos, they go from light to deep or deep to light when it comes to the shadows. And this has the two browns on opposite sides. So I think that would have been better if the browns were next to each other, because then I could see the difference between them, but yeah. And this was actually a really nice brown. I guess that I like brown shades, just that I don't use them that often. Because when I'm usually doing makeup outside of YouTube, I usually do something neutral but orange, or I go in full-blown color. And okay, then I want to go in with the two shimmers on my lid, but I'm going to swatch them because I can't remember. These are like duochrome, so I don't know if it is possible to just put them on my lid and they will show. So maybe I will actually cut my lid for this, because I really want them to be really strong. So I normally don't do that when it comes to Kaleidos, but I'm going to do it because these feels more like topper than like their more metallic, really impressive shimmers. So I will cut my crease with my glitter primer from NYX. So I will take some on a flat brush and I will just cut this. It's going to be fun now when I can see my friends do their first impression with this palette and see what they did. Okay, I'm going to take this one, or this one first, like on the outside, and that on the inside. And I really hope that these will look good together. So I will take it on my brush and press it on. And I might should have gone in with a shade underneath, but I think this is working kind of good. And then I take another brush with the other shade. Take another shade and another brush. Put it. Okay, I think I actually like this. I don't know how much you can see, but I like this. I do. So I will go in with the dark shade I had out here and just blend it a little bit. And then I go in with the shimmer head next to it. And yeah, I think I like it like this. Actually, it feels like neutral, but with a pop of, I don't know, something good at least. So I will cut the other crease. I don't think you need to see that, or you don't need to see that. Fix my base, my brows, and then I come back and we do the under eyes. And then I only have this shade left. Maybe I will take this one and have it like in my inner corner and maybe on my lower lash. We will see, but I will cut this crease and fix the rest. It's time for the under eyes. And I of course used this contour kit. And I really, really like this, or the contour palette. Yeah, okay. And I also used a blush from Kaleidos. And that is not what this video is about. So for my lower lash, I have this shade left that I haven't used. So I think I actually will go in first with this one and then take this one to deepen down my lower lash. Do I set? It always feels like I'm setting a little bit off. I don't know. So start with this one just because I don't want it too like harsh. But okay. I don't know why I say stuff like that because do I ever care? Probably not. I might actually make this work. This is enough, but I want to use all the shades because what I can remember in all my first impression with Kaleidos palettes, I've always used all the shades. So I'm just going in with this brown one and take it out here. So I dip in a little bit, tap it off, and then just put it here. So, and I'm thinking if I want to go in with this shimmer that I had in here. What? The shade I had closest to my inner corner and pop it in my inner corner. Closest to my inner corner, pop it in my inner corner. I guess you understand what I mean. And I'm going to do that. And I'm going to spray it because I don't want it to fall on my face. Yes. I am happy with the lids like this, and it feels so strange when, maybe this is not the neutral look, but like a more toned down look than I usually do, and say that I like it, it always feels a little bit strange. But yeah, I am going to put something in my waterline, put on mascara, and then I'm also going to test out the new lip gloss that came in this collection. I think this isn't that like opaque. No, it's not, I guess. So I will take something under and then put this over because I really like impactful lips. But maybe I should, do you know what? I just take a little bit and we'll see. No, I will take something over. It works like this, but I'm not this kind of girl. So this is the finished look for my waterline. I took Peach Fuzz from ColourPop, and for my lips I took a combo. So I took the lip tonic in Ambition, and then I took the Lucid Lip in Dramatize, that is the new one. And I like this look. The eyes, no. The lips are maybe a little bit like, okay. I don't know what's up with me in this video because now I'm going to say something that I never thought I would say. The lips are right a little bit too red. Who are you watching? I don't know. So time for the review, and I am going to review everything. So we can start with the lip gloss. This is like their other lip glosses. As you might know, I am not the biggest fan of lip glosses. I like the one from Kaleidos and the one from The Body Shop. It's like the only lip glosses I like because these are sticky, but they are not too sticky. And the one thing I really like about these they like sink into the lips and doesn't feel sticky after like an hour. Maybe it's because they are disappearing a little bit, but I just like it. I can't stand the sticky lip glosses because I live in a windy city and it's impossible to have a lip gloss. And also, I don't like the sticky feeling and I don't like this hair. Can you just be straight down? That's better. And if we go into the contour palette, I tested one in Cool and Light. I'm not going to test out the other ones because they will not suit me, but this one I've only used this shade, which I guess is Matte Bronzer, but because this is cool, I think it works as a contour for me. And I really like this one. I might start to use this all the time instead of the one that I have from NYX. I really like it. It is not that pigmented and you have to like build it up, and I love that about contours. I hate the ones that are like too strong in the beginning. So I really like this. So if you want a new contour, I think you should buy this because it's really good, and I really like the packaging of this. It is quite heavy and I like quite heavy things. So this I can really recommend, and I love that it has a little mirror in it. So this one I'm super happy about. So if we went to the palettes, and we can start with number 6, that is the Lunar Lavender. And first of all, we can take like the packaging. I love that they did two new Futurism palettes because I love their Futurism palettes. I think the packaging is really good. I think the theme of both of the palettes are good. I love that they keep this going because I just love it. So the Lunar Lavender palette, the one that looks like this, I think this is good. The only thing I feel with both of these palettes are if you have tested out one of their Futurism palettes, the shimmers are like metallics. I love all the shimmers in the first palettes. One in the Astro Pink is more like a topper or like a duochrome, but the rest of the shimmers in the five first palettes are amazing. These are more like some of the shimmers and duochromes in the Escape Pod palette. It is not my favorite, but I have nothing against it. I am not a huge fan of duochromes. I might be because it looks really good. But just so you know, so if you wished for that like metallic, shimmery amazingness, you are not going to get this in these two palettes, but you're going to get two, four good duochrome shimmers. Just so you know. But okay, in the Lunar Lavender, I like the color story. I think might the two browns should be next to each other, and I would change the placement of shadows, but it doesn't matter. I like this palette. I have watched a little bit now when I did my base of the videos, and some people say that these are really alike. I didn't felt that on my eyes. It might be because I am pale as a paper. I don't know. But I really like this. I think it goes good with the name of the palette. And then if we go into the Sashimi City, love the front of this as well. I don't like the placements in the palette. I wish that these two browns were next to each other, and I might think they could switch out one of them. This reminds me a little bit of the Astro Pink. It is two shades in that one that I don't think is needed in that palette. But I really like that Kaleidos is doing a neutral palette because I guess there are people out there that really want to try Kaleidos but might not be a color lover. And then it's like a waste of your money if you're not going to use the palettes. So here is your chance. So I think that is really good. And I feel like the name of the collection, Fresh Fantasy, it goes good because when I think of like fresh makeup, it's not like that crazy makeup. So I guess it's good, but I don't know what to say. But both of the palettes with the matte shadows are really good. Kaleidos has some of my favorite matte shadows. They're really easy to blend out, like this brown that I used in this look. No problems at all. And the shades I have in my crease, no problems there at all. So I really think that the mattes are the same as in the other Fuchsias and palettes. And I guess that is all. I am going to say the one thing I say about Kaleidos when I do a first impression and I talk about these palettes. If you want to try Kaleidos, I think it's Kaleidos. And sometimes I say Kaleidos. Kaleidos. If you want to try one of their palettes, just buy the one that has the colors you want. Because all the palettes are good. And now I am finished. I just wish that Fuchsiasm 8 will come soon. And I would want like a grungy dream. And Kaleidos, I could help you with that. You know where to find me. I think this collection is good. I know that if I didn't get this in PR, I would buy this because I am like a collector when it comes to Kaleidos, and I can really recommend the Contour palette. And also, if you want to test Kaleidos but you want a more neutral palette, buy the Sashimi. If you want some purples in your life, buy the Lunar Lavender. So yeah. I really hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so don't miss any of my videos. And I will leave all the prices down in the description, and I will also leave some discount codes for my friends that my friends have here on YouTube. I do not have any codes with Kaleidos, but my friends have, so I will leave them down in the description. Also a link to their website where you can buy whatever you want. So yeah, I think that was all. I am thinking about doing a Kaleidos week and do 7 videos in a row in 1 week and do one look which is of the Fuchsiasm palettes. I know that the VR Neon and Electro Turquoise is going out, I guess because they were limited edition. I don't know if they're still available, but if you want me to do a Kaleidos week, please let me know and I will fix it. It might take a couple of weeks because filming 7 videos for 1 week, it's going to take some time for me. But yeah, I really hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos. And I have already said this, and bye.